Hi, this is Billy from FormSite. In this video, we'll show you how to get started with our workflow feature. Workflow connects multiple forms together and passes values from one form to the next. Typical uses include follow-up forms, approvals, and any sequence of forms that rely on information from previous submissions. If you're new to the workflow feature, here's a quick overview of how it works. Step 1, build your forms. You'll need at least one source form and one destination form, but you can do more. Step 2, create the workflow link between the forms and connect the items from the first form to the second one. Step 3, add the link to an email notification. Here's how I want my workflow to work. When my request form is submitted, it will generate a notification email to the supervisor containing a workflow link. When the link in the email is clicked by the supervisor, it will open the approval form with the information from the request form. After the request has been approved or denied, I want to send the employee an email with the response. First, I need to build the forms. Building workflow forms is no different than building other forms. I've got my name field, an email address item for my email, and an email routing item with the supervisor names and emails so we can send the request to the right person. Once my request form is complete, I then make a copy of that form, change anything I need to, and add the items I need for the approval. Now I set up the workflow. I go to the User menu and down to Workflows, and then make a new workflow. Then I choose the source form. Next, I give the link a name. The result limit lets me set how many times the link can be used. For this example, I'll choose unlimited. Then I choose the destination form. Next is to complete the mapping to connect the items between the forms. The system enables and disables certain items from the destination form based on the selected source form item. For example, I can only map text fields to text fields. After the mapping is set, I click Save, and then I need to add my link to a notification. Click the link to add to a notification and choose the email routing item as the recipient, then set the workflow link settings. The last step is to set up the notifications on the approval form. I want to send the employee a message with the result regardless of whether it's approved or denied. The next email goes to the HR department, but only if it's approved, so I set up the conditional logic and click Save. Now I return to the first form to test the whole workflow. Starting with the first form, I submit the form, then go to the supervisor's email account. Here, I see the first notification that contains the workflow link. I click the link to go to the second form that contains the values from the first form plus the additional items. I'm going to approve the request and submit the form so I can return to the employee's email account and see the email reply. That is the end of the workflow. Let's see what it looks like in the results table. Workflow results will automatically get a workflow column with the details link, and clicking that link opens a new window showing the two connected results. I can click the PDF link to download separate PDF files of each of these results for safekeeping or printing. And I can view each result individually by clicking the View buttons on each row. Just like the normal results, I can click the Populated Form link to see it in the form, or I can also print the result. If you have any questions about this or any other FormSite feature, you can reach us at formsite.com and clicking the Contact link.